This is Hope Whitlock, Technology Integration Unit for ETEC 562. This integration unit is for a Principles of Technology course covering a chapter on sound waves. This unit on sound waves will be incorporating technology by using Google Slides and my classroom projector, including animated GIFs, images, and videos. One class day will also be spent exploring sound waves using an online simulator. The final chapter assessment will be completed in Schoology Online. Learning Theories and Instructional Design Models. We will be following Vygotsky's Zone of Proximal Development for this lesson, as we will be building on existing knowledge as we continue our discussion on waves, the specifics about sound waves. Students have already completed a chapter about the general properties of waves, so some of the material will be reviewed, while other material specific to sound waves will be new. We will be using Gagnier's 9-step model. The first 2 days will be used for activation and demonstration of concepts as students hear new information and are guided in practice work. The third day will be individualized practice with a simulation lab, while the final day will be a review and assessment of what they have learned. Here is a breakdown of Gagnier's 9 events of instruction. Here is a list of the instructional objectives or TEAs for this lesson. The intended audience is typically juniors in high school who are enrolled in our Principles of Technology class. Principles of Technology is a STEM career and technology class that acts as a substitution for physics for high school graduation. The anticipated length of time for this unit is 4 class days, 45 minutes per class. Day 1 will be an introduction and the first half of slides, notes, and classroom discussion. Day 2 will be a continuation of the same. Day 3 is for the FET simulation lab on sound waves, while day 4 will be the review of slides and assessment in Schoology. Detailed lesson plan of educational activities and samples of technology use. This is the detailed lesson plan for this unit on sound. Because I'm using Gagnier's 9-step approach, I have also broken the lesson plan down in the same way. We will gain attention by using a tuning fork to rap on the desk to make a loud noise. We will then state objectives and stimulate recall by linking what we will learn in this chapter to what we've already learned in the previous chapters. We will present new material using Google Slides while students complete the notes. We will provide guided practice by allowing students to complete some questions with my help at the end of the slides. Day 2 will be a continuation of the slides and notes. Day 3 will be a FET simulation that the students will complete in pairs. Students will be encouraged to discuss and work out any questions before asking the teacher for assistance. Day 4 will provide feedback by handing back completed work and reviewing common errors found in the students' work and discussing the correct answers before taking the final assessment in Schoology over Chapter 26. Students' knowledge will be enhanced and transferred as we continue our discussion of waves in the next chapter about light waves. Here is a broad sample of the types of technology and other items that I used to complete this unit in class. Here is a photo of the hands-on equipment we used in class to demonstrate sound. Technology is great, but students really enjoy getting their hands dirty, especially creating sound out of stemmed glassware. This is a sample slide from my presentation. I included here some YouTube videos of various sound frequencies so we could test the students' ears. Our textbook says that young people should be able to hear between 20 and 20,000 hertz. So we started at the bottom with a low frequency video as the sounds gradually became higher hertz. Once everybody had heard the low tones, we started at the ultrasonic range and worked our way backwards. The majority of the class didn't even hear sounds until 14,000 hertz, myself included. This was a fun activity and the students seemed to really enjoy it. This is another sample slide that incorporates a YouTube video that demonstrates that sound cannot travel in a vacuum. The bell is ringing and placed under a vacuum jar. When the vacuum is turned on, you can hear the sound start to diminish. Once the vacuum is complete, the sound is completely stifled, The vacuum is released, and the sound magically returns. I like videos like this because they only take a few minutes, but they clearly demonstrate the concept we're discussing. This is a screenshot of the FET simulation lab that we did on day 3. This also helps demonstrate that sound cannot travel in a vacuum, as the sound in this case is inside an encapsulated area. The difference here is that students can actually visualize the waves coming off the bell. Once the vacuum is initiated, the sound waves outside within the guy's hearing. This is a screenshot of the lab that I completed in Google Notes for students to use with the FET simulation. And this is the online assessment in Schoology. I really can't say enough about how cool Schoology is. I absolutely love it and use it every chance I get. Schoology randomizes questions and answer orders so that cheating is minimized. Oh yeah, and it grades automatically. Here's the correlation of activities to our instructional design model. Day 1 will be gaining attention, telling students learning objectives about sound waves, recalling prior knowledge. We'll also be presenting new material and providing guidance, continuing through day 2. Day 3, students will demonstrate their learning in a paired lab activity on their own. Day 4, they will receive feedback from their notes and review prior knowledge prior to taking the assessment in Schoology Online. We will enhance retention and transfer knowledge into new areas when we begin the next chapter on light waves. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoyed my technology integration unit. Thank you.